conversation that I had with a cop friend of mine. We were talking about a videotape that we had both seen, and we were seeing two different things. His side is just as important as my side. Just because I don't agree means I need to investigate myself. So, you know, that's kind of where I put the stake in the ground to think about how can I talk about this, and that's where the triptych structure came from. Started thinking about how these tapes get out there and how they affect the community, how they reverberate, and we forget about the innocent people's lives are affected by them. If someone has cancer, you know, you really only think about it until it happens to you, and then you're like, oh, now all of a sudden, I start paying attention. So I wanted to make the film feel sort of complicit, that people will take a ride with these three characters, put themselves in someone else's shoes for a short amount of time, and say, okay, now I can think about this a little bit differently than I did before I walked in this movie. And hopefully they enjoyed the process, they enjoyed the ride.
I didn't just read it and say, oh wow, I'm gonna, you know, I really have to ask around to get what I need for this. You know, it's personal, like, for me. You know, I've gone through a couple of things that some of the characters in the film have unfortunately gone through.
When we get upset and angry about something and we let those feelings overcome us, it gets in the way of us actually listening. Mm-hmm. And it gets in the way of us actually thinking. What Ray did that was so awesome in this film, these three characters, they're all so level-headed. Like, they all have their stuff and they all have their things, right? We all have got our flaws, but to the core, these guys are all level-headed in the midst of chaos going on around them.
They're very optimistic and hopeful. Mm. And that is something that we don't always see. It's usually, it's the opposite, or they're down in the dumps or depressed or something and they're trying to come out of it.
It's kind of empowering to see these people work through it and ultimately delivers hope. And I think that's what's really cool about what Ray did with the film.
We have to ask ourselves, what would you do if you were in that situation? And that happens for Manny, you know, with the tape, happens for Dennis, and Kelvin's character at the end. You know, here's a kid who's got everything going for him, mm-hmm. and you know, he could easily just turn a blind eye to the things that are happening in his community. And the more we have that attitude, it's like you're not holding the door for somebody behind you. You know, like that little things like that kind of bother me. I tried to just make the movie feel like that. Like if somebody was just gonna hold the door, it's just a common courtesy. Yeah. If we could just think about just the little things that we do in our life that way, I think we just feel a little bit better. I was raised in a single parent household with my father. I was raised by someone that had a gun and a shield. So I grew up in sort of a conflicted, you know, life, growing up in Staten Island around a lot of cops that are my friends and I've played high school football with, but they would say racist and vile things. So it was like, what? Not you, Ray, no offense. You get used to it. You're gonna get numb to like, oh yeah, I guess that's me if I have to survive here, so just be quiet. Mm-hmm. And somehow having a platform and a film to be able to say, okay, I could finally say the things that I kind of wanted to say and I've kept quiet for a long time, but I still want to do it responsibly.
I grew up with a certain level of privilege, and for some reason in my mind, I'm thinking I'm exempt. And I think Zarek also, to an extent, felt like I'm talented. I got a career ahead of me, and my dad loves me. You know, I'm okay. And then suddenly you kind of go, whoa, here's my awakening, wake up call. You're not an anomaly. You're not outside of this. You're still black. And people still look at you this way, and you're gonna have to, what do you do with that? And I think that's really powerful and really cool for young people, 17 years old, kind of going, I'm looking at Twitter and Instagram and everything going on in the world, and I don't know what to do. Well, I watch Monsters and Men, maybe I can do something, you know?
I don't have a daughter, but you know, I grew up with my sister and my mom. So I have a sensitive spot especially for women. It was really a vulnerable thing for me to have this daughter in this movie, and she didn't like me at first at all. And I don't know what happened, but she just like switched, and she's like, didn't want to leave my side. It was crazy. But family to me is the most important, or one of the most important things in life. And you can't get away from them.
My favorite movies, if you think about them, whether it's Finding Nemo or Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, they all have some message in them, you know? Right. And if you dig deep enough, you realize like, oh, like Charlie had a dream and he was just going for his dream, whether it was chocolate and it was Disney, like it doesn't matter. Genre doesn't matter. There's always gonna be the core principle of love and whatever I do at the heart of it, and you know, and caring about people.